Hello, everyone. Good evening, or morning, whatever time it finds you. Welcome back to some more Let's Play Sword of the Stars with me, your host, Tim. And let's get back into it again. Where we left off, I believe we were assembling an assault force to attack the Murugi, two of them, actually, and we were strengthening all our planets. I did do some things off-screen, but nothing that involved me having to elapse a single turn. What I did was I renamed a bunch of my fleets to make sure that I remember what their purposes are. This is a heads up. And we're still number one! Awesome! We're probably barely number one, however, if I'm telling the truth. And the game waits... Oh, wow, look at the Hivers. Who's... Hold on.
System update.
By weights, I mean it applies different weights to what it considers to be more important to determine who is the number one ranked person. Wow, okay, we're actually pretty good. Number one in everything, except for technology, okay. All right, so some quick things on screen. What did I do off screen? I renamed all of the fleets, is what I did. So, all my scouts are now named where it is that they are going, and I've renamed my places that are supposed to be colonizing after the colonizing planets that they are attempting to do. And I think that's where I stopped. Right, okay, so I think we're done with this turn, right? Yes, we're done with this turn, and research went over budget, which is why it's so low. Let's end our turn, and hopefully we get data correlation. What planet is this, by the way? Ooh, I'll want to go there at some point. Am I actually building anything to colonize that place? I'm not even building any defenses here, and as our defense fleet could surely use some more defenses. So why don't we... Wow, okay, I guess I didn't do everything I thought I had wanted to do. We'll build some geckos to help defend here.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Oh, I did mark a few other planets for colonization as well, seeing how good or not good they were. And I really should begin building more fleets able to colonize. There's no reason why I shouldn't be doing this. Let's build two newts here to start.
We will build as you command, Valcona.
Okay, all right, let's end our turn and get going. As I'm beginning to... I'll spend a whole another 20 minutes doing this.
System update.
Our scientists have finally broken out of their shell.
And before I forget, let's grab these newts, stick them in a new fleet. And this fleet's job, once we have some colonizers, will be to head over here. Hopefully before the Murugi decide to take that planet. So let's build some more stuff. So we're going to build some hatcheries over here. We'll build just two.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
And this is going to go to Badoon 2. Badoon 2. Colony fleet. Yeah. Welcome back, everyone. I'm hoping to actually do a lot more battles in this one. At the very least, attacking a few of the Purple Murugi's planets and beginning to claim them. Okay, so let's begin going through the tickets. At least that's what I call these. So, hey, Wester got colonized. Wonderful. And our defense fleet's on the way there already. We can now move our scouts to other planets.
As you wish, Valcona.
And I will go ahead and begin doing this. Frood Scout. And the Kappa Fleet will send you up this way, I guess.
Departing now, Valcona.
That's near my other ship. We don't have to do that. Go to Dorsai. Dorsai Scout. Yep, in a sphere type of... Well, actually, everything but clusters. Using your tankers as scouts is actually really a decent move. Another thing which I haven't done, but it actually can work. If you have a decent ship, and you want it to be like an extended range fighter, you can make a tanker and just put much better weapons on it. Like give it a strafe system. It won't survive as anywhere near as much damage as an armor would take, especially for its mission section, but it can still do decent damage, and that ship can reach the furthest parts of your galaxy, if you need it to. Okay, we arrived at Zeta Reticuli, and that planet is not for us. Oh, I see that perhaps Fenlaw might be interested in it, though. He has a scout sitting there. I apparently didn't rename this ship.
We embark as ordered.
Gotham. Going to Batman. That's what we're doing. All right, what's next? Barrett scouts right at Barrett. Barrett is a terrible planet for us. Not interested. Move it over here.
We will move at full speed.
Capricia. Oh, I just need a Capricia. Capricia Scout. There we go. Where else have we been? Sligia. Oh, wow. That's right. So I've named this Assault Fleet Grim Aegis. So far, no one's left any comments for me about what they wanted to name the thing. So I have not bothered to... No one has left what they wanted these assault fleets to be named, so I've named them myself. Let's add the lampreys up here. And I think we're good to go. Are we building any more ships here? We are. Another Ornette Uromastix and 3 more scaled Anoles. Okay. How many tankers do I have? 2 large newts, 2 small newts. 27 is the distance they can go. That is... 7.6. But I may want to go someplace. Let's add another tanker. We'll delay it for 1 more turn, but...
We will build as you command, Valcona.
We'll do that. Iron is built 2 ships. It's colonizers that I did just... No. Crap. Yes, I did this already. We have the Badoon Colony Fleet. And now we're building, good, the 2 hatcheries. Because I want it to arrive very quickly at that place. And we need also come up with a group able to fight off that swarm. The Aran Defense Fleet won't be able to hold the planet against them. Okay, well, we'll deal with that next turn or so. 10 ships were built at Melos. Those are probably its defense satellites. That's wonderful. Is there any planets worth colonizing around you, Melos? There's... Eitria. We could do that. We're kind of being intermingled here with... the Marugi. So that's going to be kind of... It's making me a little nervous. But they don't seem to have much in the way of combat ships at the moment, so maybe we'll be fine. In fact, I don't see anything on their planets for the most part. They've left them completely unguarded, which saves them budgetary concerns. I guess with the non-aggression packs, this is fine. Alright, anyway. Let's build a fleet able to defend Kanquan. Let's begin doing that. So we'll build a Chukwala. We'll build Iguana. And we'll build some skilled anoles to start.
Shipyards at your disposal, Valcona.
Azar, working on your defenses with 3 more geckos. Get them out here as well. Might as well continue this. All my planets get this. Again, this will not really repulse an enemy fleet that absolutely wants to take the planet, but it will, should be enough to repulse the von Neumann probes. And since those can attack at any place, they will be helpful. They also probably won't stop a swarm. They might help against a swarm if the swarm attacks, but it'll be close if they win. They'll probably end up losing though, if I'm being honest. Let's build another gecko and another skilled anole to finish it up.
Yes, Valcona. We'll have the ships out in no time.
Iron Spear down here. Let's get your ships where we want them. Okay, so we have Gila monsters. We'll add them up here. We'll add a Gila monster to the battle. I want my PD ships marked as 3. hornet can come up here. We can throw another gecko into the mix if I want to. What else are we building here for? We're building another ornate. Why don't we build... Where's my annuls? I'm looking right at them. Let's add 3 more of these as well. Actually, if we can build 4... We can build 3 at least.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Data correlation has been completed. So now, if I come up here, I can now see what it is that everyone else has been researching. So here's the children. They have missile technology, which we know. Red lasers. Fission drive, okay, which is we have as well. Gauss driver. So these are what you all start with. They have Waldo units, because we've seen hammerheads. They have green lasers. Orbital foundries. I wonder how we realized they had that. Oh my god, they have fusion! Wow, the children must be super high-tech compared to us. Okay. Oh, that's dangerous. So we're gonna fall behind technologies if we don't catch up with this. They've researched their next... Well, they're... Thankfully, the children are slow, but this is scary that someone already has fusion. Oh, wow, they have trade, because I think fusion gives you the option of then going for trade. We'll want to do the same thing soon, then. Oh, right, we can also see what types of ships they have, too. So we can see the Way 7 is a fission armor with a strafe command section and red lasers. Nothing else is on that ship, so they're pretty low-tech when it comes to combat, actually. It's really Zohanzios, the cunning, that I'm interested in. And it's only really the Luthkacht Magdad... The MK2s, which have a drone section. So I probably don't... This is the only thing. Colonizers, extended ranges, armors. Yeah, it looks like I don't need as much point defense as I thought I did. Purpose served MK4. Yeah, we don't really need that much. They have fission. They have drone technology, which we've seen them use. A void cutter drive as well. Their colonizers can hold more people. And they have combat drones. Which is what's letting them have this. We can see the technologies on their ships as well. Well, purple lasers on the humans. Good for them. They're trying to probably hold off something. We haven't seen anything with Kree Costa terrible. We haven't engaged in any battles, really. The Hyper Expanse does not have... Oh, but they have cruiser construction. Alright, so we're behind the Hivers, probably, would be my guess. Unless Fenlaw has some really phenomenal stuff. No, nothing very high-powered. This is Recombat Fissionables, I think. Yep. This increases the speed and range of their ships. We didn't get lucky enough to get this as an option. We only have fusion we can go to. Okay, good. I'm really glad we saw that. Now what are we researching? So, I'm thinking we should probably go for advanced robotics. So let's also move my tech up a bit.
We have been given the necessary sum, Varkona.
Of course, we're constructing tons of ships at the moment, so we're not going to benefit from this overly much right now, but it will be helpful in the future. This also will only take us 2 turns to research, so I'm good with that. This says... Oh, because we're going to Gotham. I already handled that, I guess. Paris Council. Okay, so that is it. What else do I want to be doing? I think we're good. We're almost done with our assault fleets. 2 more turns, well, for one of my assault fleets, and then we're heading out to take enemy colonies. Once I'm done researching what it is I'm currently researching, advanced robotics, I'm thinking the next thing we should probably research will be environmental tailoring. Because as we begin taking the Purple Morogi's planets, we're going to want them to be our planets, and they're expensive to make our planets, because they're 500 off to the left compared to us. So this should help us out a lot in that regard. Of course, it does mean my ships will be less combat ready. I'm thinking after we research that, we'll research probably plasma cannons and particle beams. And then fusion will be next, because we don't want to fall too far behind. All right, let's end our turn. I think we're good to... Oh, nope. How are your planets doing If I could, how are the planets doing when it comes to over-harvesting? All right, we have Wester now, so we don't need that ticket there. Krelar is looking okay. I think it looks okay. I guess we'll be fine. What else could I possibly want to do? We could build something to deal with the swarm that's around. Where was that again, Tim? That was... What planet is this? Gaia. No, I'm on the other side of the world. I'm gonna come over here. So the hive was near Krelar. Wasn't it? I think it was. I don't remember. I know it's around here somewhere, so we'll want to be careful. There it is. Kitrath. Assuming it's still there, it hasn't been destroyed by the enemies, but I'm pretty sure it probably is still there. We can build a fleet to try to take it out. I would want to build... What's good against them that I currently have is the thing. So let me go to my designs. So, if I go to my geckos... the gecko is not really that great with only forward-facing guns. It also has... It could work. Really, the scale of nulls would probably be better. Good rate of fire on that medium. Yeah, skilled gnolls might be able to handle a swarm. It'd be tough. They might be able to do it. Let's build a small fleet and send it over to Kiltrath to kill it. Assuming it's even still there. Can I afford to do that? I think I can. So, but this small fleet will get a Chuckwalla in it.
Shipyards at your disposal, Bakona.
And I'm still researching it in two turns. All right, let's go. Oh, we just lost Wester. How about that?
System update.
Oh, we didn't. We didn't lose Wester. Holy crap! Okay. They might not have fought us, and or we launched a single planetary missile and blew them up. That the humans can reach there, though, makes me very nervous. Or maybe the humans were there already. I didn't notice them. Okay, well, anyway, let's go through this stuff first. So, we've arrived at Teohaskios, and it's not a planet for us. Wow, actually it is technically a planet for us, but that is really expensive, so we're not going to worry about that at the moment.
We will move at full speed.
Prion Scout, who's next? Addy Scout 2, for some reason I named it 2, arrived over here. This is a great planet. But that's all the way on the other side of everywhere. We'll still mark it. For the future. And our scout will move.
Your word is law, Vakona.
To Prism. Four ships build in Sligia. I think we're only building one more thing left, and then this massive fleet will be ready. We want to get our scaled annuls up here. Yeah, I probably don't need all of this point defense at all. I have probably invested way too much into point defense. It won't be terrible. This will be fine, Tim. This will be fine. And we're building one large new, and that will be the last thing. Next turn, this fleet will be sent off to take out Cassandra. Aaron built two ships. These are the two colonizers, or hatchery pods. And we can get them to...
Our path is clear.
Engaging warp engines.
Dune 2. We built a ship here at Archon. Archukwala. This will be fine. Let's now build some stuff to deal with those swarms. I don't know if the point defense systems are good against them. We can build a Jesus Christ lizard and see if it's good enough to help us against it. It can't hurt. If nothing else, it's just a waste of 6 resources.
Yes, Vakona. We'll have the ships out in no time.
Melos, why are you building... Oh crap, why are you building this? I just started. Are you going up here? Oh, yes. I think you're going up to Itria. That's expensive. Was there another place you were supposed to go with this fleet? We have Kalken. Oh, Kalken. That's what this is supposed to do. Okay, so let's manage this. That's going to be Kalken's defense fleet. And as before, let's get these guys... begin getting them set up. And then we might as well keep building the things we need.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Azar's defense fleet, I think, is finally done. So our gecko can go here. We can bump you over a little bit. I think that will be fine. Cool. Done. I don't think I need... Well, we could build another colonizer for Saramush, size 8. I really should do that. I really should do that. Come on, let's do it. 2 newts to start.
We will build as you command, Valkona.
Fortress build in Wondergore. Let's add these 2 iron spear. These are your scaled annuls. We can... Oh, I hate when I do that. Okay, well, it'll be fine. I suppose it'll have to be fine. Move you up here. Iguanas, large newts. Okay, I think these can actually be in combat a tiny bit. And we can still fit some more ships up here. We'll add the scaled annuls then. Kind of add them over here, I guess, to start. And I'm allowed 2 more. Can we build... What are we building? Nothing else at the moment. Let's build some bearded lizards, the laser version. And then we'll probably have to build another refinery.
Shipyards at your disposal, Vakona.
Yeah, I'm going to want at least 1 more large newt. We have 2 repair drones, a bunch of more geckos. Let's build another 2 Gila monsters. And we'll have to hope this will be able to cut it.
Yes, Vakona. We'll have the ships out in no time.
Oh, we're going to need assault ships over here. If this is going to be attacking planets, we need it. We need those. So we're going to want probably close to 4 or 5 of those. Where are my lampreys? And as long as we're waiting 3 turns, we'll build 2 more skilled annuls.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
We actually destroyed it with our planet missile. Good job, West. Good job, Western, or whatever that planet was called. Parentar's infrastructure has been completed. Awesome. We have 2 newts here that we no longer need to kind of hang out. They weren't even needing to be here at all. We'll send them out here.
Your word is law, Vakona.
That's really far away. But we might as well get this done. Okay, you know what? I'll rename the scout ships off screen. Okay, the rest is just exploration notes. Our research is still done next turn. I guess that's... Oh, while we're here, let's build the light defense batteries. No reason not to.
Shipyards at your disposal, Vakona.
Research should still be done next turn. Let's go ahead and end our turn.
System update.
The mystery has been solved, Varkona.
Garnet colony attempt has arrived at Garnet. All right, Garnet, let's colonize you.
The Empire has conquered. Another pearl in your crown, Varkona.
Gia defense fleet has arrived at Gia. We'll flag it as a guard. And we're not over-harvesting here, and we totally should be. Pascal scout arrived at Pascal, and doesn't surprise me, no one wants to use Pascal anymore. Let's go ahead and keep moving, ya.
Departing now, Varkona.
Conquan colony attempt has arrived at Conquan. Let's go ahead and take this planet as well.
New lands to conquer.
Addy scouts arrived at Addy. I see what happened. Okay, well, they were named incorrectly for both sides. We've arrived here. We can't get away. There's no other planet we can reach. We can't refuel here because we don't have an alliance with the birds. So we will just scuttle our ship.
Your word is law, Varkona. This craft will be decommissioned.
And that is our last large newt. All right, Grim Aegis. Let me make absolutely sure I'm happy with you. And I think I am. Okay, let's do it. They can move a total of 31 spaces, which gives me enough to move here and back.
Your word is law, Varkona.
24 destroyers, 11 cruisers on the way. Archon, we're still building something to deal with the swarm, assuming that the swarm is still there. The swarm will, I think, will come behind us as well, so when we arrive, so we should swap where our vessels are located due to that. We'll rename this. And then we will build some more skilled annuls, which are probably these and our Gila monsters are probably the best things we have to fight them.
Shipyards at your disposal, Varkona.
Melos is still building more ships. They're being added directly to the Kanquan defense fleet, which is fine with me. Build some skilled annuls. You up here. We want another. We can probably build a Gila. And then we can build a Gecko. And then we need a Newt to help get us there.
Yes, Varkona. We'll have the ships out in no time.
Azar built some ships. Oh, I see we're building another, some more colonization. Get you out here, Newts. Where were we going? We were going here, weren't we? Oh, wow. Yes. Yep, we're taking Saramuch. So we'll rename you. Colony attempt. We will build some hatcheries. Actually, how is my planet looking? Yeah, 7 million. This is fine.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Charitar's building its light defense platforms. Wondergore built some more bearded lizards and what have you. This is fine with me. These are the laser ones. I want them out here, actually. They should be near the front line. Like that, I think. Okay, and then we have some extra geckos, an extra Gila monster, extra iguana, two repair drones, some more. Oh, we have two Jesus Christ lizards for later on. We just need the assault shuttles. They also can move 32. They would be going into the purple territory. That is Fenlaw's territory. They would be going here to Thives. How far is that? 13. We will probably need... Yeah, we're gonna need at least another newt. Probably two more.
We will build as you command, Valcona.
We have advanced robotics. Awesome, so everything's gonna be a little cheaper for us now. And we have combat drones. Wow, that's probably pretty lucky for us as Tarka. So this will let us build drone ships. Construction drones taken to the next level have become autonomous combat vessels, able to engage and harass targets far away from their command ship. This is what we've seen the Marui using. But I remember that I wanted environmental tailoring.
This may be the egg we need to crack, Valcona.
Defend K. Grocco. Where is that? That is far away. Everything you want me to defend is far away. What's attacking you there? It's not the Pyvers. They're over here. It's probably the Marui, maybe. Who are you under attack with? I can't tell. Can I tell? No, I can't tell. Okay. Okay, well, let's just... Oh, wait. Instead of this, let's just research Tarkesian living... No. I want this more. We really should begin researching some defenses. We'll do that next. Terraforming Uri is completed. Wonderful. Now the rest will just go into infrastructure. It'll take a while here, but that will soon be ours. Yep, we've explored Pascal, we've done that as well. Let's look at my planets over-harvesting and make sure we're not draining more than I would like from these planets. Krelar looks fine to me. My morale is kind of low on a lot of my planets, only 50 or so, or 60. We'll need to build some police cutters soon. If I even remember how to do that. Alright, that is it for this turn, I guess? Yeah, I think that's it for this turn. Why am I parked here? Oh, because that's Kalken. And we're busy colonizing that planet. Okay, let's end our turn. Actually, how's our tech? Number two in technology, but now also number two in income. Okay. Oh no! And oh, colony trap! I bet you that's what's here. We're just gonna auto these, because we've lost whatever showed up at Kalken.
System updates.
Yup. Okay, that means we have to build another fleet able to go there. So. Azar will. Well, Azar, you were building stuff anyway for this. We're just gonna rename you. We're just going to rename you, and we'll have to get you up to back to here again. How about that? Ah, it's so annoying. All right, especially because the defense fleet's ready to go. It's a shame we didn't reach there first. All right, so our Gila monster is also set up. Our last gecko is set up. We have a newt to get us there. Where's Kalken?
We will move at full speed.
Right, go over there and hold it for us if you're able to. And we'll build another newt, and we'll build some more hatcheries to get there as well.
We will build as you command, Valcona.
Okay. Now, meanwhile, we did establish a colony on Garrett. Cool. This extended range can just be leveled. This is the turn one ship.
Your word is law, Valcona. This craft will be decommissioned.
These can be used as new scouts, and we can move them around.
The Armada moves as one.
Row fleet two. Tosi, and we died there to the Marugi. We arrived at Kopral, and that is not for us. Way too expensive.
Cartographer, chart the path.
We arrived at Wester. a turn after it was attacked by the humans, but we're here now, thank goodness. We'll flag this as a guard. And then we can move out these two as scouts. So we'll move you up to here.
As you wish, Varkona.
You will go there. Archon's still building some more bug hunters. They're being added directly to this fleet. We have some more scaled gnolls. That's right, Tim. They're going to come from this way. I'm going to want all our ships up here. We're already building two more Gila monsters, and that will be fine. Melos, the Kalkan defense fleet, is already heading out. Shame, several turns too late. Azar, you built the first hatcheries. You're building the rest of them. I'm gonna send two fleets over to Kalkan to help take it. Parentar, you finished your light satellites, and I think that's all I need to do for you. You'll now just sit there and earn me some cash. Wondegor has built even more ships. First of the Lampreys has been built. We have two more Gila monsters. I want those before all this stuff. Do that. I think we're building Lampreys and then Skeleton Knolls and another newt. Yep, two more newts, and then that fleet's going to be heading out to fight enemies. We've lost a battle here, which we expected. A colonization trap. Yep, that sucks. And the good news is that, well, actually, there is no good news. It's just us losing. We have lots of these guys using our planets as lifting off spots, and there's a guy right here. What fleets are here? I can't actually see them. Can I double click on them or something? How can I tell? There's one ship here. One ship detected, but I can't see what it is. Okay, how about that? We might need stronger sensors. They might have something protecting them from my scans. Okay, well, that's it for this turn. Let's keep on keeping on. We're doing pretty well, all things considered. That's the Greenhivers. Holy crap! That's a huge amount of things. 20 Nostromos.
System update.
A few ships approaching, Varkona.
We've taken nearly all this world can give, Varkona.
Okay, let's look at what we have here so far. So the Maltus Scout detect another Fenlaw planet that belongs to them. They finally moved everything over as well with the climate hazard.
Your word is law, Varkona.
Kadola is a member of Fenlaw's group.
Our path is clear. Engaging warp engines.
Sphinx is colonizable, but it's so expensive at the moment. We're not really interested.
The Armada moves as one.
Actually, we should move over here. Lots of our scouts arrived at places today. We lost whatever we fought there. We arrived at Copernicus. There we go, Tim. Yep, you could do it. No one believed you. Not even you believed you, but you did do it. Okay, we're allowed two more vessels in this, and then we need some newts. So let us build. I think we'll build one large newt and a small newt. And then we'll also build two geckos. We could also build a repair vessel for this.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Melos, You built your three ships. They're not being good. They're being added over here. We're just going to rename you. Another colony attempt. We built some ships at Azar. But I think those ones were added over here. Again, we will attempt to colonize Calquen. Where was that planet? That was there.
As you wish, Varkona.
Wondergore, I think we handled you already? We did not. I want the scale of gnolls bumped up to there. Do we need to build anything else here? We're building one more nuke. We have a range of 28. Is that enough to get there and back? It is not. Not there, at least. It is enough to hit Thives, though. And we'll have another small newt there. So, we should be fine. Oh, looks like they're trying to intercept my single scout. In space, good for them. We've lost a battle there. They have purple lasers. Oh, that might have been my ship, though. Okay. Krelar, you are over-harvesting. I am still fine with that. Is that the only planet of mine that's over-harvesting? Let's double-check everything. Is that the only planet that should be? Wester should be over-harvesting, and it is not. So we will do that as well for you. Any other places that are not profitable that should be? Serenity? Oh, Serenity, I forgot all about you. How are you looking? 21 on the climate hazard. Wonderful. Serenity's probably going to get a larger fleet held here. This is a magnificent planet I would like to hold on to for the rest of the game. And because it has an asteroid monitor, I'm nervous about the von Neumann probe showing up here. Because the asteroid monitor will level the von Neumann probes. The probes will just attack it as well. So we would need to hold this planet. We need to put more effort into holding this planet. Because if the von Neumann show up, we're going to get a berserker there. Okay, so is that all we want to do? How much research going? 3 more turns? Can we get it to be 2 more turns? We can. Okay, that is good. How much longer till we're there? Excellent. 2 more turns. We'll arrive at Cassandra. Let's end our turn. I forgot to look at those ships he had. We'll do that next turn. We totally lost his tanker. There's something at Prion that's probably the swarm. And in deep space, we're just going to auto that because we've lost. All right, so let's see what's at Prion. The swarm. Yep, I expected this.
Taking position, Kandai.
You might as well charge him. You're dead anyway. You can't get away. Oh, looks like when you blew up, you took out a few of them with you. Awesome work, Mr. Tanker.
Incoming!
What do these things count as drones?
We lost a destroyer,
Connor. I guess we'll find out when we arrive here with bug hunters.
System update.
Prion scout arrived at Prion. Badoon colonies arrived at Badoon 2. Badoon 2 is already colonized by Fenlaw. And there's a... But the Marigi have the have the asteroid monitor here. Oh, we wanted to colonize Badoon 2, but we arrived way too late. That's a shame. Okay, well, let's clear the notes at the moment, because we can't possibly claim this. And instead, we need to go someplace else. We can try Tupile. That's kind of expensive for a tier. No, it's not that bad. Let's go over there. Actually, it's 10 away? Yeah, that's fine, Tim.
Our path is clear. Engaging warp engines.
Shambhala Scout has arrived at Shambhala 2, and that is not a planet we are interested in.
The Armada moves as one.
Archon built two more ships. A large newt and a newt. So next turn, we will be set, and then we will launch. Actually, I should have some backups in case we take ship losses against them. Let's build a few more scaled. Can I fit an extra little newt in there? I can.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
Melos, let's move out again. Or do we want to go up to Iran? I mean, it's going to take a while to get there, Tim. No, move Kalkin out.
As you wish, Varkona.
And begin building another group to colonize.
Shipyards at your disposal, Varkona.
Ooh, wait, no, stop. Stop, 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 stop. Stop. We're going to lose all our civilians if we keep doing this. No, we don't. You're not that far along, Melos. We can't lose our civilians. It's going to cost us money. I'm going to wait. Wondergore has built another small newt. I think that was all I wanted. Are we building anything else here? We can go 29, which should be enough to reach Thives. They're going to see me on the way, so this should be a massive fight when we arrive here. We have what we need. We have as much as I'm willing to spend so far. So, sure, let's do it.
We embark as ordered.
Not building anything else. All right, good luck, guys. Lost a battle at Capricia. Swarm infestation remains. Lost a battle in deep space. Terraforming at Mintar is completed. Wonderful. It's working on infrastructure there now. We don't have a defense fleet there? Okay. Let's begin settling that.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
How's our research looking? One more turn. Hopefully we'll get it. I guess that's good. Oh, and holy crap, we're going to hit their planet this turn, I think. So, this time I'm going to put you pause in the game a bit as we do this battle so I can give some better orders to my troops. Just a heads up. Things are just gotten serious when we begin attacking enemy planets like we're about to start doing. Okay, and how are we looking over here? Erai, you're just working on infrastructure now. Okay, let's end our turn. Actually, how are we doing, by the way? Okay. 2-1, and... I keep forgetting to look at the human battle lines. Oh, wow, this poor planet. This planet belongs to us. They only have some defense satellites surrounding it. Okay, let's do it.
Reinforcements have come.
All right, so I've immediately paused the game, and our sole objective at the moment...
Attack group responding.
See, these are all geckos? What are these? We have a single bearded lizard, another gecko here. This is a laser
attack
one.
Group responding.
Okay, so really quick, I'm gonna
joining attack group.
Assign him to rank 3 and move him up.
As you command, Tycho.
These are all geckos, so these this is another bearded lizard.
Joining attack group. Power to engines now. Attack group responding.
These two will head over here.
Yes, Kandai. Coming about.
We added this section 2 because they're armed with missiles. I do not want to bombard the planet at all if I can avoid doing so. Alright, so let's unpause and get these ships moved to where I want them to go.
Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust.
Whoa, look at them. Kind of missed their mark. All right, that's good enough. Let's do it.
As you command, Daiko. As you command, Daiko.
Now, I don't want attack to attack the responding planet. So I have to try to hope that I can... I also want to destroy the satellites.
Attack group responding.
Group 2, I'm going to have you hold... Oh, okay. Let's... only fire, what does it say? Fire only at my target.
Attack group responding.
Same thing with your missiles. Oh wow, these are not set to number 2. Hold on to your missiles
attack
as well.
Responding.
A whole minute and a half has gone by already as we're slowly drifting towards the planet. Here come the missiles. That's what we expected. But our point defense systems will shoot them down.
Yes, Kandai. Coming about.
Yep, it's the light defense platforms we're interested in slaughtering. We're taking some damage. No, we're shooting down their missiles. Perfect. We may not get all of those defense platforms this time.
Kandai has spoken. Get this ship moving.
Only fire on my targets, please. I'm assuming that means that you'll still use your point defense systems, though. Let's watch and see if that's the case. If not, then... Good. Excellent. Yep, we're shooting them down. What are you firing at? Stop. Only fire at my things.
Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust.
Oh god, we're gonna level the planet anyway. This is not at all what I wanted to have happen. Let's see if we can move them out a little bit. There's a planet missile coming from below us. We'll make this planet unharvestable, uncolonizable at this rate. Oh, they have point defense systems on their thing, shooting down all our missiles. Oh wow, I like the point defense Gauss weapons.
Coordinates received, Kandai.
Okay, oh no, some of those are going to the planet. Please don't go at the planet.
Power to engines.
I don't want any missiles to strike the planet. Please don't do that. I want to just destroy these drones.
Coordinates received. Maneuver drives to full.
Everything fire on...
Yes, Kandai. Coming about.
On my targets only. I should have probably selected all of them to start and said only attack this.
Kandai has spoken. Get the ship moving.
We're not firing missiles, though, which is interesting. I don't know why we're not firing missiles at the long range. That's going to be annoying, though, because that means that these will survive.
Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust.
Those might destroy that one. And we might have enough time to destroy this one as well as it comes in. Actually, we shouldn't even be moving forward. We should just be sitting still and firing at them. And be moving and moving my ships around to get better shots at these things.
Taking position, Kandai.
fantastic. We did get a few of their defense drones, but unfortunately, we didn't get nearly as much as I would have liked. I guess I don't understand how this is working very well.
We must withdraw for the moment, Tycho.
System update.
We have made a breakthrough, Varkona.
Okay. We don't want that climate hazard going any more to the left. Let's manage this fleet. Oh, actually, so first thing first, did we take any damage? We do have repair stuff here. Actually, no. We should do this in the order in which these are listed. So the Garnet Defense Fleet has arrived at... Garnet Defense Fleet has arrived at Garnet, and we will flag it. We will immediately begin over-harvesting here as well. Our Pascal Scout has arrived at Wazan and got blown up. We arrived at Cassandra. All right, so let's deal with this now. So there's no more civilians left on the planet. We only have Imperial forces. I would like to not bomb them anymore. I would like that to not happen. So we're going to go to repair. And it looks like we only took some light damage. Took some very light damage. We can just hit repair all. This available gets restored at the, I believe, at every single turn. So we can just do that.
I hope your enemies fared worse, Varkona.
They did. We killed all the civilians on Cassandra, and now we're dealing with the Imperials that are still left there. While we're here, we're now going to redesign this fleet a little bit. We don't need this point defense group at all. We're going to keep a Gila monster, and we're going to keep our bearded lizards. Kind of. Where is our laser GCs? Do we have any? I thought we definitely did. My problem with a fleet this large is it becomes tricky for me to find them. Is this one of them? Nope, that's not one. I don't see any. I guess we didn't bring any with us. And you guys are screaming at the screen how you've seen them, but I don't see them here. Okay, so I don't see them here. Let's take the bearded lizards with the lasers. And they will have to hold out for everything else. Our Gila monsters, and we will bring some... No, I will also take out the geckos, because I don't want any more missiles firing. No more missiles besides the few I have on my Chuckwalla will be coming along with us. These two Gila monsters will go attack the drones. And we can add... I would like even more bearded lizards with us. I guess I didn't bring as much as I thought I did here. Alright, all the lampreys will be deployed. With the bearded lizards set to help guard them. Because they're going to make a beeline right for the planet. And hopefully be able to strip it of the remaining Imperial forces down on it. Up you go. There you go. Here, because why not? Don't want to be too close to each other, but I need you protected by these point defense systems. I think that will do it. Let's move you a tiny bit over. And then you have to be moved over a little bit because it's all wrong. Perfect. What do we still have over here? We have enough for two more ships. Come on, Gila Monster, you can do it. You can get in. There we go. Okay. So what do I have? I have a PD. No, I don't have any laser versions of my GC lizards. Okay, well, we do have beer lizards, period. We have... Oh, wow. Awesome. We have another laser one. Let's get you there. You guys will be set to 3. And we'll use a point defense. Oh, whoa. Actually, we can use the laser one over here. And we can get a different one on this side. And all of you will be assigned 3. This group is going to be hunting down the enemy satellites, which are still circling the planet. Now, we'll still have more stuff pop in to existence, because we have significantly more things than they do. Just as a heads up. So I should probably put... No... It's going to drag the things which are listed up here in. Let's move a Gila monster up top. Let's do this. Okay, that should be good. What's next? We've arrived at Beowulf. It's a human colony. We arrived at Eri 2. Oh, it's a nice little Oh. It's not that nice. Let's move on. Move over here. Size 2.
The Armada moves as one.
Two ships built in Archon. Oh, are we good? I think we're good. We have two more geckos. I have two geckos, period. Let's have... All right, that should be good. And I think we're building more... Okay, and the rest of it will be done next turn. And then this squad will be able to go out and hunt down the swarm. Bob is busy building some more defenses for Mintos, I believe. The planet's not called Mintos, but it's close enough to what it actually is called. Move you down there, scale the nulls up to the top. On. Let's get you up here, you two. Get you up here. And then we want... Then we want even more. We want some more geckos. And a newt, because we're going to need at least one newt to get us there.
You heard him. We must increase the fleet.
And we have environmental tailoring. Wonderful. We've engaged him at Cassandra. We destroyed 41 million imperialists, killed any civilians on the planet, very few of them, reduced infrastructure a tiny bit, and we destroyed only one of their defense satellites, it looks like. Okay, now before I forget anymore, what are the humans using? They had 20 of something. Was it Nostramos? Oh, assault shuttles. 20 assault shuttles. So they're going after planets with that fleet. Interesting. Alright, good to know that that's the case. And where are we going with this fleet? Mintar is the name of the fleet. Okay, what else are we doing this turn? So we're done with our research, which is amazing. That is an amazing research to help us with all our colonies. In fact, if we go look at Wester, we're now moving this, well, still can't really tell, 2.67. But it is significantly better. We'll get people faster, and we'll move this much faster over as well, the climate hazard. Wow, 10. That's pretty awesome. Oh, but we are also over-harvesting. Oh, but there is almost no one there, so that is a great upgrade, I'm thinking. And where is... Oh, Garnet. Garnet belongs to us now. We can clear that out. Is Garnet over-harvesting? It is, but very slightly. Wow, one terraforming infrastructure already. I know it takes a long time, but that's... I'm still impressed. Where's Serenity? So we're moving 40. That is fantastic. So four more turns. And Serenity then will be working only on its infrastructure. Okay, let's go to our research. So we just got our method tailoring. So population growth rate and terraform efficiency have both increased. Next, what can we research this time? Population growth rate. Okay, so this gives us... We can colonize planets we couldn't before because we are able to tolerate better. And we have a 25% additional terraform efficiency. And population growth on all worlds by 10%. But we're going to research some defenses, I think.
We have been given the necessary sum, Varkona.
We'll begin by Tarkesian living steel. I think this is the thing we have to put on our ships, just as a heads up. How are we looking when it comes to stuff? Where we might be number one. It'll be very, very close, though. Okay, and we can do at least one more turn, I think, in this episode. So let's do one more turn. Let's end turn. Actually, Tim, we may want to... Since now I've seen what the enemy uses, I think I've built way too many point defense. Like, this setup, I don't think I want this anymore. I think I want you back in here. With my Gila monster up front. You're going to be up front like this. And then I want another Gila monster instead up there. We're gonna go with this to start. Okay, so is that really it? I think so. Yeah, I'm done with this turn. Okay, let's end our turn. Actually, I was a research. Yeah, one turn. Alright, let's do it. I need 7 defense satellites now. This is gonna be very tricky. But we're gonna have to try it anyway. Oh god! The Von Neumann have shown up on Soror. Okay. We should be able to hold them off there. Let's do these two battles.
Fresh ships. Ready for battle.
Awesome. That's another Gila monster. We'll get it over.
Coordinates received, Kandai.
Let's just
attack group responding.
Add all of these.
Joining attack
to attack group 1 and move them toward the
yes,
planet.
Coming about.
Group 3 will also move up, but not quite as much at the moment.
Attack group responding. Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust. Attack group responding.
Might be able to use the asteroids to hide us a tiny bit until we arrive. Nope, okay, they've seen us.
Attack group responding. Coordinates received, Kandai. Attack group responding.
Alright, move in. Let's do this.
Maneuver drives to full. Attack group responding.
Yeah, yep, fire on all the missiles.
Spoken. Get the ship moving.
This group's gonna set up and try to knock down any more defense satellites that arrive from this side of the planet. As much of them as we possibly can.
Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust. Attack group responding.
This group
taking position,
is gonna be moving close to the planet and then releasing the assault shuttles.
Attack group responding. Power to engines, now.
Come on, guys.
Firing on all batteries. Kandai has spoken.
Move up.
Get this ship moving.
Might not kill that one.
Attack responding.
Alright. Time to do it. Assault shuttles. Launch. Actually, wait. Let's wait until this thing passes us.
Assault shuttles launched. Taking position, Kandai.
This group is just going to be holding here like a wall, trying to destroy any of the light defense platforms that arrive.
Power to engines, now.
These guys will attack the planet and greatly reduce the population. Only fire on my things I want. I'm targeting.
Target locked.
Actually, hold twos. I don't need any more missiles. Hold all guns. I want you waiting until that thing's within range. Our assault shuttles will strip the planet of most of those people. They're still firing anyway. So I don't understand what's happening.
Yes, Kandai.
You're just not listening. Too eager to fight.
Kandai has spoken.
This is dumb. I should also shoot
the ship moving. Firing on all batteries.
Ooh, we're hitting our own ship back there, Gecko. Get your butt to the front.
Attack group responding.
Good. Hold all your weapons. The planet is over. There's nothing left alive on the planet. Wonderful. In that case, we can fire everything we've got at whatever's left. It's amazing how effective even a single light, like a single destroyer with point defense systems is. They are amazing. Alright, let's see if we can move up a little bit now and try to destroy the last of the satellites before the timer expires.
Firing on all batteries.
There's another one left.
Yes.
We have a minute? I think we might be able to do this, but we're gonna have to hope this is the last one.
Target locked. Yes, Kandai.
Excellent. All the assault shuttles also made it back. So, like I said, I believe they did. So we can use this fleet to punch something else in the face if we want to as well. Another one. Okay. I don't think we'll kill it in time. Yeah. Only 5 seconds left. It's not even glowing.
We must fall back or be supplied.
Ah, that's right. The probes. Okay.
What can it be?
Oh, that's bad. They're already here.
Yes, Kandai. Coming about.
We need to move everyone up.
Kandai has spoken. Get the ship moving.
And just do it. Yeah, we have to hope we can fend them off. We do have help from the planet below, of course, as well. Let's unpause. Next, I want... What does this do? Oh, I can bomb my own planet, I guess, is what that means. I do not actually want to fire my missiles.
Responding.
The last time I did that, it actually activated the torpedo launcher on the von Neumann probe itself. So I'm going to hope that they simply not firing at it, it won't fire back at us. Because these little drones were more than a match for. Oh, that's the planet itself firing its missiles. Yeah, we can't stop that from happening. Nice. Good work. Good work. Awesome. Yep, this is what these defense fleets are for. Stopping this probe from stripping the planet bare. Because there's no way our defense satellites would be able to actually stop von Neumann probes. Oh, you're gonna hit this guy, aren't you? Okay, good. Let's look at the probe, by the way. Kind of crazy looking thing. You know what just occurs to me? When I've been giving instructions to a lot of my ships to attack, I right-click on the thing. I should be left-clicking on it. Let me see if one of my ships will move up if I left-click.
Yes, Kandai, bringing guns to bear.
Oh, okay. I've been doing it wrong this whole time. I should be left-clicking on the thing. A right-click on it probably moves it to attack. Oh, please don't destroy my CNC ship, planet.
Kandai.
Oh God! Hit my ship. Ship.
Power to engines now.
Oh, hello. We have torpedoes. do your best and face it, because we're probably going to lose ships now. It's still producing even more and more and more. I also don't want to destroy the von Neumann probe by accident, so I'm also going to fire my missiles on the off chance any actually get through and begin damaging it. Our objective is to hold it off, and nothing else. I think it realizes, okay, maybe it wasn't that we struck it, maybe it was just time. Oof.
Kandai has spoken. Get this ship moving.
I want him moving away. Oh, it stopped firing. That's interesting.
Yes, Kandai. Full power to thrust.
Oh, wow. Nope. It totally didn't. Let's get more ships on that side.
As you command, Daiko.
We are targeted, Daiko.
No, no, no. No, no, no. I want you to come back around this from this direction. It's firing all its torpedoes in that direction, so we will set up our ships in a tighter formation to deal with it. This is pretty exciting, actually. I like just holding it off. This is what I should have done the very first time. That was a complete accident when I was moving all my things up. Let's move you back a little bit, Gecko. Whoa, whoa, you're kind of getting careful. You could collide into each other. Bad. Ships can collide into each other. They can do it. It's really bad when it happens. It's a lot of damage. Okay, I think we got this. Let's just advance time now for the remainder. Excellent.
System update.
The planet is nearly stripped to the bone, Varkona.
We didn't get the research. We're over budget. Okay, well, the good news is then we can just take all that money. Okay, so this will be the last turn I do for this session. So let's just look at what we've done. So a fleet arrived down here, and that planet is expensive. Very expensive for a size 2, without a lot of resources.
Departing now, Varkona.
We arrived at Tully. It's a Fenlaw planet, size 9. Lucky.
We embark, as ordered.
We arrived at Galantro, 4 ships built in Archon. Okay, this will probably do it for this fleet. Bug Hunters, I think, is ready. We have some scaled nulls. We'll get them bumped up here. Okay, I think our Kill the Bugs fleet is ready to go. Where was the swarm last seen? They were around here somewhere. Kitrath.
We will move at full speed.
Let's do it. Built some ships in Bob. This is the Mintar defense fleet. And we'll need a few more things. We have some geckos. Let's get them up here. I really should be building just destroyers to deal with. So one of those little probes can totally consume a cruiser. So I probably should not be building cruisers, honestly. Because we're pretty set up to destroying these things with what we've got. And that strafe section is so nice against them as well.
We will build as you command, Varkona.
Yep, doesn't it figure? And we have almost taken all of Cassandra. Right, actually, let's go back to that really quick. So there's only one thing left on this planet. It's a size 3. So I'm not really interested. Okay, on one hand, it has some infrastructure on it. We could come here and take it, but that's expensive for a size 3. I'm not really interested, I think, in claiming that planet. That's a shame, actually, too. Darn, are attacking that planet. I didn't know how to stop it. Okay, let's go ahead and repair.
I hope your enemies fared worse, Valcona.
Yeah, we just killed 258 million Imperialists. Trust me, they felt significantly worse than we did. Okay, so what do I want to do? My objective was to take over their planets, but this is going to be hideously expensive. Okay, well, we don't need these ships. They can be put back here. We can move the bearded lizards back here as well. And we can deploy, we can reset up our squadron. And we can just let this auto-complete, basically. I've been repeating words multiple times. I'm good at that. Where are we looking for? Oh, we can probably just do this automatically. Just this one defense drone. We should annihilate it with just this little group. We'll still set this up like this anyway. There's no reason, Tim, not to have your entire squad present in the battle. No reason at all why you can't do it. Arc, okay, that looks good. It's balanced. Okay, what are we doing? I guess we'll stay here and wipe out that last defense drone. The climate hazard on this planet is so expensive for us to actually claim it, unfortunately. It would take a long time to make that one of our planets, and a size 3 with 4,000 resources, I don't think it's really worth it. Not anymore. Not this planet. We'll still sit here for one more turn to blow up this satellite automatically next round, I think. And the Von Neumann's attacked. We didn't lose anything, and we pulsed their ships. Oh god, 104 resources. Okay, we do not need to do that. Or maybe we can do it one more turn. A size 7? One more turn. And the rest is just scout stuff. So I think that'll do it for us, everyone. So thank you guys for watching. So we've taken one of the... Well, we eliminated one of the planets for the Marugi. It's a shame that their climate that they prefer is so far over here. I'm going to start picking fights against someone... Oh, someone Blasky, look at this. We're losing rep with these three. We have a ceasefire with the children, and they weren't happy. I wonder if they actually have... Oh, hello! The humans have fusion warheads as well. They probably have fusion technology then, don't they? Okay, we need fusion. That needs to be the next thing we research. It has to be. We're going to fall behind everyone else otherwise. So we'll get that done, hopefully at the beginning of next turn, or starting next turn, once we're done researching Tarkian living steel. Okay, well, that will do it for us, everyone. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.